anything to pick up here. Can't be leaving anything behind. Even though ultimately, you know, grabbing, well, I mean, it's flowers. I'm reminded of a particular gif that I've seen where, I think it's the heavy from TF2 is running through Skyrim, and he picks up a flower and then he falls over onto his back because it became over-encumbered. It's just such a black and white experience in this game.
Welcome to the Villamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Pardon me, my lord. Oh. Would you care to hear me play my lute?
Oh.
If you fancy a bit of music, let me know.
So, what do you play?
I play the lute. If you'd like to hear something, it only costs 5 gold.
Merely 5 gold? Lady, I would pay twice that to hear you play.
That's so sweet of you. I'll tell you what. I'll play a special song, just for you, for no charge at all.
Why, thank you. Okay, then. Get a little background music in here, and, hello.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
Haunted? I know that all sorts of things lurk in barrows, but what else can you tell me?
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul.
That barrow is pretty much smack in the middle of town. I don't suppose the spirits come out and haunt the farms as well, do they?
Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow?
If you want, I could go inside of it. See what's going on. I've been inside of my fair share of ruins already.
If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest.
All right, then. Has anyone else ever gone inside of the barrow to look around? Knowing if anyone found anything previously would help.
About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night we heard screams from the barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again.
Well, that's certainly something that I should know about. Thanks. I'll proceed with caution.
If you're headed up to the monastery, watch your step. It's a long way down.
Man. Alright, ghostly voice, I'm coming for you. What have we got here? Before the ages of man.
Ooh!
It's only an increase to illusion. That's one style that I should really give a shot to, if I play this game through on stream any again. Trying to do an illusion-only run. Well, great. Not quite, but now. Ooh. Okay, not in the way there. Oh, come on! Ah, there we go, finally. Great. Alright, now I'm locked in, more or less. Here we go. Yank on this. Okay. Ooh! Crap, man. I almost turned into a pincushion there. Alright. Where are you, stinky little specter? Shall fear the dead. Get out of here. You ain't got nothing against my, armor spell. There we go, armor spell. Oop, sorry, Lydia. Yeah, I know. Well, well, well. Windelius. I couldn't imagine. Lockpick. Filter of the Phantom. I think that's Filter. That or it's Filer. I don't know. I'm not gonna spend time. What do we have here? A journal. Journal of Windelius Gatherian. 4th Era 200. 18th of Morning Star. I've set up camp inside of the barrow. This has to be the place. According to all of my research, the burial chamber should be located here. All I need is some time undisturbed to find the claw. It must be hidden here somewhere. Fourth Era 200, 25th of Morning Star. Had a close call today with that fool, Wilhelm. He came close to entering the barrow, but I was able to scare him off by rattling some pottery shards in a bag. These people are far too superstitious for their own good. Gives me an idea. Fourth Era 200, 28th of Morning Star. After a few failures, I've come up with a mixture that should do the trick. The glow is perfect. I should look exactly like one of the supposed spirits the people of Everstedt believe is haunting this barrow. Going to test it out tomorrow. Fourth Era 200, 29th of Morning Star. Success! It worked better than I could have imagined. All I had to do was wander around the entrance to the barrow at night and wave my arms about. I had to stop myself from laughing aloud as they ran away. This should keep them at bay while I continue searching for the claw. Fourth Era 200, 11th of Hearthfire. Almost half a year has passed and no sign of the claw or any clue as to its whereabouts. This is becoming maddening. It has to be here. Can't risk hiring any assistance, so I'll have to continue alone. Fourth Era 200, 20th of Sun's Dusk. It isn't here. It can't be here. This isn't right. It must be the people of Everstedt. They must be onto my ruse, and they are toying with me. They want to find the burial chamber on their own and keep the riches for themselves. Fourth Era 200, 18th of Evening Star. Why? Why are they tormenting me? Why not just destroy me? Who am I? My head is becoming clouded. I can't remember anything. I have to read my journal to remember my purpose. Am I part of this tomb? Am I meant to guard it? What's becoming of me? First Era 1050. They shall not take my treasure. They shall all pay dearly for their crimes. Any who set foot within these walls will taste my wrath, my power. I am the guardian of Shrouded Hearth Barrow. All who oppose me will fall.
Welcome to the Villamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Hey, Wilhelm, do you scream?
We don't get many visitors through here, unless they're headed up to High Hrothgar, of course.
Well, Wilhelm, I'm back from the barrow, and I found Windelius, as well as his journal. Take a look at this.
Let me see that. I can't believe this. It was all just a fabrication of this Windelius character. I can't believe we were so stupid. Well, least I can do is give you something for taking care of him. If you won't accept it as a payment, consider it a gift.
Well, this will come in handy, Wilhelm. And it's a little bit ironic that this is my reward. But in any case, before I go, I'd like to stay the night.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Okay, it doesn't look like there's anything else. Alright, Lydia. How many words is this? Try not to get me killed. 6 words, Lydia. Simple. 6 words. Try not to get me killed. I know that you have a habit of, trying to get me killed because you don't know how to be aware of traps. Oh god. Great. Like, right now, look at what you did, Lydia. Reason why I don't like followers in this game. Die! Oh, nothing like a kill cam. Lovely. I don't really play two-handed characters that often. One of the great things about playing a character that like relies on using swords, specifically two-handed blades, it's just like, yeah, you can really do a kill cam. Which are great, but at the same time, they can be kind of annoying. Oh, jeez. That was really short. Okay, then. Just loot these screwballs. These, undead, fetid, rotting, useless pieces of... Actually, the Draugr are surprisingly well-preserved, given how old they are. I mean, they're all carrying ancient Nordic equipment. They hold together amazingly well. Something else that's interesting is that the Draugr in Skyrim, which, I consider to be the definitive versions of Draugr, they are way more defined. It's not that. The Draugr in Skyrim are like the definitive version, like I just said. this isn't a trap. Not at all. Yep, sure enough. Well, you know what? There must be something down there, right? Sure enough, coin purse. I don't know if there's anything else. Oh, Lydia. Oh, Lydia, please tell me that you can get out of there. Yank on this chain. Well, I hope you have a nice life down in that little pit of water. Whoops. Ooh. Oh, she warped right out of it. Okay, that's good. What's up at the top of this set of stairs? Master. Oh, God. Come on, please. Oh, finally. Oh. I've been at that for like... I've been at that lock for like 10 minutes. And then, of course, come on, expert already? How many picks am I gonna have to go through? Alright, let's just take it all. Like, after the number of picks that I have wasted getting to that chest, getting to that loot, it would feel completely ridiculous. Anyway, what was I saying? Agent, oh god, the number of traps in this freaking pit. Alright. Whoa, whoa. Almost walked into that one. Okay, so as I was saying, the Draugr in this game, being the definitive version of the Draugr, because of how much more detailed they are, it's actually the first time that the Draugr showed up as far as... Ooh, God, Lydia! You nearly... Oh my God. Anyways, Draugr have shown up in Morrowind before. That was actually the first place that they showed up. Technically not Morrowind, the base game. It should have been Bloodmoon. Hello, that's a lot of skeletons. And they looked completely different. They actually looked a whole lot like... Oh. Well, I was going to try to cast a fire spell, but that works too. Why didn't the oil catch on fire from... You know what? I'm not going to ask. Anyways, the Draugr kind of looked like ghouls in Blood Moon from Morrowind, which is, you know, a lot of people don't know, but the island of Solstheim in the expansion Dragonborn here, it's actually from Morrowind. That was whenever they first made Solstheim. I don't know how many people are aware of that. Anyone who's, you know, like, got a clue about the wider existence of the Elder Scrolls as a game series, you know, but... out of here, you stupid wrestling Draugr prick. Jeez. And stop speaking in that weird ancient Nordic tongue. If you're insulting me, please at least do it in a way that I can understand. Like, I'm not gonna respect you anymore because you're, like, trying to cut my face off, but still. If you're gonna insult me, please at least make it possible for me to understand the trash talk that you have going. I mean, trash talk is kind of pointless if the person that you're hurling it at doesn't understand you, okay? I'm just saying. You're missing a big part of the art of trash talk. Oh, okay. Maybe I can summon on the other side of these, There we go. Lydia! Oh, jeez. Lydia, would you please... Just stay there, okay? No, don't walk towards me. Don't walk towards me, stay where you are. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, I took a little bit of a cut, but I'm alright. A trapped dungeon is about the worst place to have followers. Shut those things off, jeez. Oh, hey, look. Draugrs, just sleeping. Let's get rid of them. Die. Useless schmucks. Isn't schmuck Yiddish for penis? Alright, there we go, and I'm gonna go ahead and trap you. Trying to steal my kills there, I see, guys. Nice of you to let me have all the glory for taking out a sleeping douchebag. Ooh, almost stepped on that. Okay, I cannot trust my my health to... Ooh, God! Okay, just rush past it to get away from it. Because Lydia is definitely gonna... Yeah, there you go. There goes Lydia. You're surrendering to a door! It's a trap, Lydia! All you have to do is walk around it! Look at me over here! I'm having to MVP this whole thing because you suck! Gain some spatial awareness, for God's sake! And they call you a House Carl, for God's sake. Have you finished outsmarting the pressure plate, Lydia? I don't know if I can trust you to do such a thing. God's sake. Okay. Okay, that's empty. Oh, great, it's an expert door. Oh, no, wait. I picked up the key. Sweet. Jeez. This place just keeps going. I'm used to short dungeons. I'm used to short dungeons. Ooh, gold. So, anytime that a dungeon lasts longer than a short period, I'm just thinking, when will it end? Of course, then again, the longest dungeon that I think I ever went through. Ooh, Elven Gauntlets. The longest dungeon I think I ever went through in my life has to be... I forget what it was called, but it was like... I think the dungeon had like 6 or 8 different sections to it. You know, it's like you go into the dungeon... Not even worth taking. You go into the dungeon, and then when you think you're getting really deep, you find a door that it's like, you know, dungeon level 2. But it's like, you know, the, you know, big cave... Like, it's called Big Cave, and then you get down so far, and then you find a lower level of it, and the door leads to Big Cave Catacombs, and then you get to the bottom of the catacombs, and it's like, Big Cave, you know, Depths, and then it's Big Cave Sanctuary after that, and so it's just like, how many times? So, I remember it was like 6 or 8 levels deep, and the areas were huge as well. And it was part of the expansion to, it was DLC for Oblivion, that added, Mehrunes Razor, which is a Daedric artifact, which there's a big reason why it wasn't in the base game, which I won't get into, but, okay, so, we've got Dolphin, you guys are all in my way, okay, Dolphin, let's look at the rest of these. So, nope. I think it reverses. Yeah, it reverses. So, the next one is Hawk. The last one is Dolphin. So, Hawk, and then Dolphin. Chances are the last one is a serpent. And my money was right. So yeah, it was the biggest freaking dungeon that I had ever gone through, and it was one of those situations where it was like, okay, I completely cleaned out my inventory, and I had special equipment equipped so that I could, like, carry unbelievable amounts of equipment, and I still had to leave, like, really good expensive stuff behind in the dungeon. I knew that that was coming. Looks like nothing else. What does that do? Nothing. Great. And what do we have behind door number 32? Is there anything useful behind here? There's nothing like having a random loot cache and find out that it's just like, oh, you found, like, a lockpick. A Corundum ingot. I don't know that that was really worth the trouble that I went through to get it, but... Oh well, not much I can do about it now. Linen wrap. Ooh, minor magicka. And a burial urn with just a tiny bit of gold. Alright then. Is this gonna be the boss chamber up here? No, it's not. Shrouded Hearth Depths. You see, this is what I'm talking about. It's like, Shrouded Hearth Chambers, now the Shrouded Hearth Depths. Oh, well that's not a boss room. Or, you know, a massive encounter room. All right, Lydia, let's prep for this, okay? First off, I'll armor up. Second off, I'll summon. Okay, Lydia, let's do this. Lydia! What are you doing? Don't get locked out of the boss room like that. I have to do this on my own. If I wasn't a conjurer, I would be in so much more trouble. I cannot believe it. Why do I even keep Lydia around? She's so dumb. She does such stupid things. Get out of here, restless, talker, useless, douche. Jeez. Okay. Ah, that's the wrong spell. Triggering the wrong spell. I'm trying to soul trap. There we go. Come here. Die. Okay. Oh, I don't have enough magicka. Regenerate. Regenerate. There we go. This, my friends, is the reason why... Die. Yeah. This is the reason why I don't like the Atronach Stone. It's because you regenerate magicka 50% slower, which... if I can be cheap and not use potions in battle, so much the better. I don't want to capture any more Draugr until the big boss shows up, which should be right here. All right, boss man. Soul trap you. The Draugr. Not too much longer before Deathlord starts showing up. Come here, douche. Die. Oh, God. Oh, hey, nice. He was about to kill me. Oh. All right. Nice. An ancient Nordic sword. That's enchanted. Just gotta pick up the bits and pieces off of these guys now. Well, hello, Lydia. Not like you were used to anything in that fight. You couldn't even shoot your arrows between the bars. You incompetent... I'm replacing you as soon as I can. And I mean, granted, I know that it's a failure of the overall AI in the game and not so much of the character Lydia, but still, it's like, yeah. Anyways, I've leveled up a lot, so let's go ahead and increase my magicka. I'm just gonna increase my magicka. I'm gonna go for health again after I get my magicka up to 200 without enhancements. So, I have since written down the perks that I need. So first off, we are going to take, Atromancy. There we go. Double the duration of my summons. Next up, we will take, not Mage Armor. It's not Adept Alteration. We will instead take, should be this one over here. Magic Resistance. Block 10% of spell effects. Nice. And let's see, two-handed should be the next one that I go for. Oh, hey, check it out. I can actually take the next level of Barbarian. Nice. So there's that, and... still got one perk left to spend. It's Speech, I think, is what I'm going to go for next, just to improve my selling prices, because this is legitimately useful. Whereas I like to sometimes say it's legitimately useful. All right, there we go. Perk spent. Let us continue looting these douchebags. These douche bros down here. Bone meal. Nope. Just arrows. And corundum. And nothing else. All right, so let's head out to the loot chamber. I hope I have enough space in my inventory. If I don't, I hope that Lydia still has some space. I'm not, like, being very outward about it, but I'm treating Lydia like a dumping bank until I have a home base to store stuff at. And given that I need to get around to actually getting a house set up in Hearthfire. Those are spikes. Here we go. Come on. Oh, for God's sake, I can't. Target for the life of me. There. Alright, pop that lock. Grab the coins. And what do we have in here? Dwarven mace. Gold. Alright. Man, there's not a lot of anything good down here. I'm waiting for the moment whenever the random bits and pieces that spawn in these dungeons turn out to be like dwarven equipment and elven equipment. Just something better than iron and steel junk. You know what? I don't think that there's anything down in the water for me. Let's just absorb the word of power here. Kind's peace. That must quiet and or quell it's probably got something to do with Kinnereth and, like, quieting down the wild animals and whatnot, so. Pacify, there we go. Pacify. Alright, back out at Shrouded Hearth. Entrance, basically. Oh man, there's no secondary loot chest? Well, that's a crock. Talk about a shame. Alright. So, I'm all done with the Shrouded Hearth Barrow now. I don't think that I'm gonna find anything else on the way out here, unless I'm really, really lucky. Sometimes you'll find something useful lying around. Oh yeah, sure enough, steel warhammer. Not worth it to me, but, you know, still. I'm gonna have to find someone to sell this stuff off to, too. Open says me, stone wall. The irony of our friend Windelius, who was basically camping on top of a route straight into the primary chamber the whole time. I don't think that there's anything that I missed in these front chambers. Nope, nothing at all. All right, Lydia, let's call it a day, and let's head back to the village that I completely forget. Iverstead, that's it. Let's head back into Iverstead. Let's sell some stuff off and continue our adventure.